very, very, very creepy plastic bunny sat in the corner there, wearing what appears to be a knockoff Disney hat. peekaboo, YouTube. Hello, my name is Comedian, and already I've forgotten the English language. My name is Comedian, and I want to give a big welcome to all NF fans. Hello. Please don't leave me. Hello, NF fans. Hello. And I say hello, NF fans, because today is my very first NF reaction. And if you are a subscriber of mine, which, you know, if you have any common sense, you probably aren't, then you might know that I get very excited about reacting to new artists for some crazy reason. It's almost like discovering new music is fun. Who would have thought? But yes, today, NF. I've only said one thing. Two things if you include the day. So yes, today I'm reacting to NF. I've had quite a few requests for me to react to NF now. I guess there's some crossover with fans of the other artists I've been reacting to recently, like Why Don't We, and maybe Billie Eilish. I don't know. I don't really know anything about NF, but what I think I know, or what I may have heard, whispered, NF, here's details on NF across the corridor. Whispered to me in the night, in my brain, in the small hours of the morning when I am at my most sad. I think that maybe he's a rapper, although I'm not sure about that. I could be completely wrong about that. I get the basics wrong on many things, far more than any human being should really and still be alive. But that's besides the point. Today I've decided to react to the song Intro by NF, which seems like a good place to start. It's called Intro. I hope it isn't some postmodernist thing where it's actually an outro and it's his last song he ever made. That would be confusing, and I hate being confused. Ugh. And yeah, I guess before I get this reaction started, I just want to thank you guys who actually asked me so politely and kindly many times, I react to this guy. So thank you too. Liu Kang Hoi, Sydney Jackson. Puppy Love, NF Real Music, who I hope isn't just the actual artist NF on an alternate account. That would be kind of awkward. And Dhruvi Patel. Thank you so much to you guys for requesting this. I hope the wait was worth it. I shouldn't have said anything. And yes, let's go. Let's see what this Mr. NF man is all about. Let's see if he even says what NF stands for. Noddy fans. Nearing fatality. Numpty flip. Naughty fish. Nagging friends. Who knows? Let's see. Oh, okay, so heavy on the imagery, also heavy on the very English-looking weather, sort of grey, bleak, one-tone colour sky. But anyway, back to the imagery. Caution tapes wrapped all around a human being. I mean, that speaks for itself. And you see what I did there? I cleverly reacted without really saying anything about anything, which is genius work as far as I'm concerned. Oh, okay, it's Zora's logo, and we're back to the tape again. Wow, it's like living in music video Groundhog Day. Is the caution tape, is that saving us from him or saving him from the world? I guess we'll find out. Okay, and of course, because I love all things bunny related, my eye was drawn to the very, very, very creepy plastic bunny sat in the corner there, wearing what appears to be a knockoff Disney hat. I mean, this, I could make a whole video about this just by itself, but I'll spare you. I'm looking like I'm gonna get it, you probably don't get it. I come in your house with a microphone looking like I'm about to set up a show in your kitchen. I'm out of my— Ooh, okay, so yes, he's definitely rapping. I recognize rap. I have heard some of these rap songs, as the kids call them, in my time, and this is a rap. That's a rap. Except not a rap, as in he's finished, he's clearly just getting started. But that is a rap in the song sense. And my goodness, that was fast. I don't know if I can follow this, which is encouraging. If you've just tuned in and you're brand new, listen to my channel, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to be honest right now, I don't know if I can follow what this guy is saying. So, you know, stick around. No, I'm going to turn the bass, the cheesy bass effect on my headphones off and see if I can follow this better. Maybe turn it up slightly. And maybe get my ears cleaned. And maybe get a new brain. Okay, with all those things in place, I should be ready to go. No, I failed again. Alright, I'm gonna turn this up even more. Is it turning up? I can't tell. Turn up. I put it on this volume. Destroy my own ears slightly. And alright, I'm just gonna roll with it. If I don't get it, I don't get it. I'm a fool. I talked over it. That's on me. Alright. This time really though. Last time.
I'm looking like I'm gonna get it. You probably don't get it. I come in your house with a microphone looking like I'm about to set up a show in your kitchen.
Okay. I'm following on a bit more. So he's talking about money and how I don't get it, which is very accurate. And how dare you, Mr. NF or NF? Is it NF or NF? NF. You've really cut straight to my soul there. Are you making me feel NF the emotion when you said, I'm looking at the money. I think that's what you said. You probably don't get it. Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Oomph. And he's looking like he's got a mic in his hand and set up a show in your kitchen. That's very specific lyrics, and I love it. I love the energy too, it's so explosive.
I'm out of my mind, but I feel like I'm in it. If I never make it, don't make any difference. I'm stuck in the killer, you know what the deal is. I never know telling when I'm in the building. And if it's a monster, I am a villain.
Ooh, there's some really good bars going on in here. He said, forgetting what all the bars were. There was one in particular I liked, which I will now go back and find again. I might even edit this out of my video so that you can't know how silly I am. Although I bet the later version of Comedian will decide to leave it in to embarrass me, you naughty boy.
And NF is a monster, I am a villain. My music is sick and you don't know what ill is. You better get back, I don't write any filler. I write what I feel and I'm feeling a million.
That's it. I don't write any filler. I write what I feel and I'm feeling a million. Oof. Oof, that hits hard. Obviously, excellent wordplay. Basically, did what I would do, which is say the same word several times but had the same meaning. But he did it in a very clever way, which is saying three different words that sound very similar, three different times that have very different meanings to add up to a big meaning. That's where I fail when I communicate. I say the same thing three different ways and I don't actually make any extra meaning on top. This man has nailed the art of communication with the English language. Thumbs up, Mr. Nth. What was I saying again? Right. He doesn't write any filler, and he's writing what you're feeling, and he feels a million. And let me just correct you, Mr. Inf. You should be feeling 14 million, because I think that's how many views this video has. Ding!
Quiet, you hear it? I'm about to lose it. I'm on a whole different level of music. Don't treat me like I have no clue how to do this. You better rethink what you're thinking and move it. Now picture me writing when I was a kid trying to make it in music. I think it's crazy.
There's a very, I mean, this guy is obviously going to risk being compared to Eminem because he's like an angry young white rapper. And he does seem to be kind of like going for that niche. I'm not saying he's saying the same message, but it's, you know, it's a guy in a very bleak looking Midwestern town wearing a gray hoodie, kind of slightly crouched to his knees. And he's a white guy and he's yelling angrily. Like, there's going to be Eminem comparisons drawn. I'm sorry. It's just how it is. And I'm wondering what his background is, you know, because Eminem's anger came from the streets, but I can't tell what this guy's streets were. I wonder if he'll tell us what his streets are.
Studio time trying to get on my music so people could play it. Keep it 100, my music was terrible. Learn to get...
Did he just say my music was terrible? Well, you know, real recognize real. I fully tell everyone how terrible my videos are when they first tune in, so I respect the hustle, you know? Honesty, best policy.
My music was terrible. Learn to get better than one that I made. Go back to my moments now, but most of you people, you probably don't know what I'm saying. Hold up!
Most of you people, you probably don't know what I'm saying. Well, I do understand what you're saying, Mr. NF, because I turn the basement off of my headphones, I turn the music up really loud till my brain hurts listening to it, and I'm sitting here going scrunch face, and I know what you're saying. Oh, you meant metaphorically. No, I don't know what you're saying, sorry.
What you witnessing now? Don't try to figure me out. I grab on that microphone, jump in the crowd, they was laughing at me. Who they laughing at now, huh? I laugh at myself. Some people, they looking like wild.
I guess if you weren't an underground fan of NF before he blew up on YouTube or whatever, how he blew up. People blow up in weird ways these days. This guy could honestly be the son of the billionaire who didn't actually do any hustle to get here, but, you know, he probably did hustle a bit because he seems like he's very talented at rapping. But besides the point... Yes, is besides the point, because I forgot my point. Yes! No, I remember now. The point was, he's basically talking about all these haters and how he made his music better, but this is my introduction to you, and his song is called Intro. So it's kind of, it is an interesting paradox to be like, here's an intro about me, I made it past all the haters, and I got better, and I came from nowhere, and it's like, well, did you? I want to see receipts. See, I respect that strategy. Laugh at yourself. I very much adopt that with my channel because I know that I am laughable, so I make sure the focus is truly on laughing at me, because psychologically, if you laugh at yourself first, the impact of their horrible, cruel words won't affect you at night and you won't stay up reading their sad, cruel comments until 2 in the morning. It works, guys.
The moment you told me that you was a rapper, I couldn't believe it. You believe it now? Step in the booth and a murderer. You never heard of a rapper that killer like I do. I sleep on the couch in the studio.
I'm fascinated to know who NF's target audience here is. I wonder if he is targeting the same age group as Eminem kind of targeted. I don't know if Eminem deliberately targeted this age group, but I feel like when he first came out, he obviously had widespread popularity, but like, you know, I must have been, you know, in my teens or even earlier than that when Eminem was like really blowing up. No, probably earlier than that. right? I'm not ancient yet, right? Right? But yeah, my point is, you know, I was young when Eminem was blowing up, and everyone I knew who was young, like, especially loved his music because it had that kind of anger in, like, the angry side of music you really like when you're younger. So I guess I am curious what the average age of his fan base is. If anyone knows, pop it in the comments. Yeah, let's get back to this. Murderer, you never heard of a rabbit. But I'm saying that because the music video is very much like a Call of Duty montage with the effects. But I'm a wreck. What's taking for buying? Maybe you burned it. But either way, I'm gonna wreck you. Look at the industry, look what it did to me. Like, I can very much appreciate this guy's bars and his rapping talent and all that stuff. You know, the bars, lovely bars, stacked up side to side, you know, bars on bars, and all on the beat. You know, rhymed well, on the beats, all you could want from a rap song, really. But he said, look at the industry, look at what it did to me. And then it cuts to a picture of him wrapped in yellow caution tape. Is that what the industry did to him? Or is this a metaphor? Because, you know, I want some backstory. Like, when it comes to rap, I want the wordplay and there's the sick beats and the sick flow, but also the backstory. The backstory is essential. And maybe I paused it prematurely. He might be about to deliver the backstory in the very next verse, which would be embarrassing for me. But as it stands, I'm just going to assume as it stands for now that he was kidnapped by the industry as a collective and they wrapped him in yellow caution tape and then popped him on a street in downtown Illinois. But it doesn't mean you'll never make it if you never cry. You put a whole lot of money into it, you better be ready to give it to- Watch out, NF, that car is coming. And if he isn't part of your video shoot, he's going to be like, what the heck is happening here? There's a man in a grey hoodie bouncing up and down on the balls of his feet. Oh, this is such a Call of Duty montage. It's changing, no way to tame this. I am an artist. Look what I painted. Hang up the caution tape, I'm dangerous. The caution tape because he's dangerous. Music is changing, no way to tame this. I am an artist. Look what I painted. Hang up the caution tape, I'm dangerous. Look, does anyone know where my brain is? Does anyone know where my brain is? I mean, you know, that's a reasonable question. I almost feel like that lyric is a bit cheesy, but at the same time, I emotionally agree with that sentiment. I agree with a lot of the things he's been saying. I also often wonder where my brain is. Really don't care if I'm nameless, y'all just driving around. I know where my lane is. I keep not competitive. This is a job for me, it's adrenaline. Don't try to box me and I am able to come in the ring. My punch is a weapon. I never drink, but I live in these bars. Okay, some of these lyrics are cheesy. I never drink, but I live in these bars. Like, come on, man. First of all, I don't believe you don't drink, although he probably doesn't. And second of all, I forgot what I was saying. Put you in charge, care what you think, I'm breaking your car. I'm on top of it, sound the alarm, and wake up the neighborhood, rap in your yard, and carry the speakers up under my arms. We've come a long way from boomboxes. Are those Bluetooth speakers, or is he just carrying studio speakers around that can't actually play music? Because that would be awkward if you were. Like, imagine if you walked around trying to show off carrying speakers, and they were like, play us something, and you were like, can't, they're not hooked up to the cable. They're just speakers, but I look cool. The jokes, I ain't joking, you come in a session with me, I'ma show you what dope is, and when I say dope, I ain't talking about smoking, I'm talking about music that has an emotion. I look at this mic, it's part of my family, take it away, I'm coming to find you. Who is taking his mic away? Who's running around stealing this mic? Whoever you are, if you're watching this, don't do that. It's mean. And mics are pretty cheap these days. Just don't. Look at the team I'm dealing with. These people ain't playing around. Looking back, I got a lap. I was in a whole different place a year ago. I look at the map, and thank you, God, I swear it's a miracle. Yeah, I feel like it's a bit of a contrast to big yourself up for the whole song and then say thank you, God, at the end. I feel like you either got to take credit for it or give all the credit to God. I heard God plays for keeps. God doesn't share credit. Just saying. Beautiful. At least I can do if I murder a beat. Take the time to go to his funeral. Woo! Okay. All right. Okay. Fascinating. Okay. The last lyric, a little bit cheesy. If I murder a beat, I should go to his funeral. It's a little bit cheesy, but you know, there is a place in rap and also my heart for cheesy beats. My entire existence is basically one long dad joke. I am one long joke that my dad and mum made. So I don't hate cheesy rhymes. I just feel like it's interesting because the intro very much wasn't cheesy and it was very serious, and the whole tone of the song was trying to establish seriousness. Like, look how serious I am. But then the cheesy beats kind of throwed it off a bit for me, but also, you know, I'm too judgmental and cynical. And ending, it's interesting. I don't know if it's a deliberate paradox, but beginning the song on a very, I would say, non-cheesy, like very serious, like on flow, hard-hitting bars, and then ending it with a cheesy bar, it's an interesting contrast, really. Yeah, I'll be thinking about that until, well, at least until I have the next slice of cheese, which will be probably about 5 minutes from now. But anyway, getting off topic once more, thank you so much for suggesting that, guys. I genuinely really like that. That is now one song down. I will say I'm definitely curious and excited to react to more of this guy's music. Please suggest any more songs you want to see me react to of his or any other artist in the comments. Definitely want to check out more of his stuff. But obviously from this one song, I would say that he raps excellently, has some really cool lyrics, and some interesting cheesy bars. And he also seems very, very angry. I wonder if that anger is a theme in his songs, or if it was more like his, you know, his braggadocious fight track, like his, like, "Hey world, here I am, listen up, guys. You big meanies who took my mics away, you listen up right now." Maybe that was the point of this track, and the other tracks are really laid back and lovely, and he sings in very soothing voices about the aches and pains of filing a taxes on time, which I haven't done yet. But yes, thank you so much to all the people who requested an NF reaction. I hope you enjoyed it. Like I said, please do pop your comments, feedback, whatever, in the... what is it called? It's not on the comments. It's not on the comments, in the comments. Pop your comments in the comments, he said, completely failing at the English language. Do that. Suggestions, please do like the video if you enjoyed it. Let me know what you liked about it in the comments, or what you hated about it, or me in the comment. That was, okay, let's not do that. Let's not do that. My computer is freaking out. Let's not do that. Stuff. Suggestions. Thank you so much for watching. I've forgotten what my name is. Somebody please, please send help. Please subscribe in lieu of sending help. Don't help me, just subscribe. That'll help. And remember, if you're a fan of oomph, then click that subscribe button with some oomph. Didn't make sense. I guess the whole video didn't make sense.